Good morning. I hope you are wide awake this morning. I'm coming to you with a thought for the day. So just hang on because we're going to read some scripture, then we're going to get right into it. So hang on. You got your cup of coffee? I hope so. We are going to read from Psalms chapter 92. We're starting in verse 12 and we're going to read through verse 15. It says, "The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree." Have you seen a set of woods where all you see is palm trees? They grow like crazy. That means the righteous shall flourish like the palm tree. That means we should be flourishing. We should be filling this country. We should be filling this atmosphere with nothing but Christians, with righteousness. Amen. It says, "The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in his courts of our God." Well, we're planted. We received Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, so we're planted, so we should be flourishing. I love this next part. It says, "They shall still bring forth fruit in old age. They shall be fat and flourishing to show that the Lord is upright. He is my rock, and there is no unrighteousness in him." There is no unrighteousness in him. But the thought of the day, is verse 14. "They shall still bring forth fruit in old age." So as you grow older, you should be bringing forth fruit. That doesn't mean you use the excuse, "Oh, I'm just too old to do this. I'm too old to testify. I'm too old to share God's gospel." No, he said that you will still bring forth fruit in your old age. That means the elders of the church, there's wisdom there. That means that wisdom needs to be passed down to the young ones. The problem is there's a disconnect between the young generation and the old generation that we call, and there's no wisdom being passed down. I need you for the thought for the day to pass down some wisdom to the young generation. I need you, as you grow older, don't give up on God. Don't give up sharing the gospel, because he said that you can bring forth fruit in old age. "They shall be fat." I have that part. He's already taken care of that, but that's not what fat means. "And flourishing." So, are you bringing forth fruit? Are you flourishing? Just a thought for the day.